Assalamu alaikum. I am Amiyo Bhattacharji. I will take higher math class today. Class 10, higher mathematics. A board question of 2020, Dinajpur board. Dinajpur board 2020. Question number 2. A is equal to 1 plus log base x yz. B equal to 2 plus log y zx. C equal to 3 plus log z xy and a square plus 2 is equal to 5 to the power 2 by 3 plus 5 to the power minus 2 by 3. Question number 8, if b equals to 4, show that x by y equal to y by z. Number b, show that 5a cube plus 15a minus 24 equals to 0. Question number C, prove that a to the power minus 1 plus p minus 1 to the power minus 1 plus c minus 2 whole to the power minus 1 is equal to 1. Dear students, you are required to copy the maths. You are required to copy the math. Okay. Solution. Question number 8. It is given that b equal to 2 plus log y base zx, and it is given b equals to 4. Therefore, we can write their left hand sides are equal. So, their right hand sides will be equal. B is equal to 4. That means log y base zx equals to 4 minus 2, that is 2. That is y square equals to zx. We know this formula. What is the formula? The formula is e log a base x equals to y. Then a to the power y is equal to x. Actually, this will be interchange, nothing else. So we can write here x by y equals to y by z. Y into y equals to y square. Z into x equals to zx. So question number one is shown. E number is shown. It is really very easy for you, and I know all of you can do this math very easily. It's not hard. Copy it. Now question number B. In question number B, it is told it is related to A. So why something is given related to A? That is A square plus 2 is equal to 5 to the power 2 by 3 plus 5 to the power minus 2 by 3 is given. That is good. We get a square equal to 5 to the power 2 by 3 minus 2 plus 5 to the power minus 2 by 3, which means a square equal to 5 to the power 1 by 3 whole square. We know power is multiplied. So 2 and 1 by 3 will be multiplied, and we will get 2 into 1 by 3, that is 2 by 3, minus 2 into 5 to the power 1 by 3, 5 to the power minus 1 by 3. That is, it is 5 to the power minus 3 whole square. Similarly, we get this. Side note is to be given here. That is, 5 to the power 1 by 3 into 5 to the power minus 1 by 3 is equal to 5 to the power powers of, during multiplication, powers are added. During multiplication, powers are added. So the powers here 1 by 3 and minus 1 by 3 will be added. So 1 by 3 minus 1 by 3, that is 5 to the power 0 is equal to 1. 2 into 1, it is fully and fully 1, right? Now we have got it as by 1, this part, and this percent is value is 1. 2 into 1 is equal to 2, so we don't have any change. Or a square equal to, this is a square minus 2ab plus b square. A square minus 2ab plus b square. So a minus b. A minus b whole square. Okay? And from both the sides we have got the same power that will be omitted. To get A is equal to 5 to the power 1 by 3 minus 5 to the power minus 1 by 3. This is written as equation 1 now. Now we have got the simple method, very elementary method. As in the question is degree is 3, degree means the highest power of the variable, leading variable. So in this question, degree is 3, so we have to cube both the sides. It means a cube is equal to 5 to the power 1 by 3 minus 5 to the power minus 1 by 3 whole cube. Side note is to be given, cubing equation 1. The equation 1 has been cubed. The equation 1 cubed here. Copy it. Or a cube is equal to, now it is a minus b whole cube. A minus b whole cube is corollary. What is this corollary? A minus b whole cube is for a minus b whole cube. This corollary is a cube minus b cube minus 3ab into a minus b. So a for 5 to the power 1 by 3. This is a cube minus b cube. B cube minus 3ab. 3ab into a minus b. A minus b. I have put it in the corollary of a minus b whole cube, that is a cube minus b cube minus 3ab into a minus b. Or a cube minus equals to 3 permitted, so 5 to the power 1 minus 3 permitted, so we will be left with 5 to the power minus 1 minus 3 into previously we have got it 1, and its value is given in equation 1. Equation 1 A is equal to 5 to the power 1 by 3 minus 5 to the power minus 1 by 3. We can give a side note, that is 5 to the power 1 by 3 into 5 to the power minus 1 by 3 is equal to 1. That was proved earlier. And from equation 1. And from equation 1. I have put the value. I have put the value of this part as by A from equation 1. Implies that a cube equals to 5 minus 1 by 5 minus 3a. Now just get LCM in the right hand sides. That is, a cube equals to 5, 25 minus 1 minus 15. So 5a cube is equal to, here 15a, 5 a cube equals to 24 minus 15a. So 5 a cube plus 15a minus 24 equals to 0. Short. Please copy the math. All of you are required to copy the math. Now we are going to question number C. A is equal to log x y z, right? So what we had, therefore 1 by a equals to 1 by log x y z, that is a inverse equals to log yz. I think that is log a base b into log e base a equals to 1. That means log a base b is equal to 1 by log b base a. I can give you another example, that is log 2 base 3 can be written as 1 by log 3 base 2. You see the base has been interchanged. Here base 2, but here base is 3. So try to understand. 1 by a means a inverse. Here I have got the application of inverted loop. 1 by a means a inverse. Here what actually has been done, this and this have been interchanged. YZ has been now base. Now, this is equation 1. B, what is B given? B equal to 2 plus log yzx. But we have to find B minus 1. Implies that B minus 1 is equal to 2 plus log yzx minus 1. What I have done? I have subtracted 1 from both the sides. Why we have done it? As per the requirement of the proof. I have subtracted 1 from both the sides. As per the requirement of the question. Or b minus 1 is equal to 2 minus 1 equals to 1 log y base zx. Okay. As it is 1, what should we do? Log y base y. Y base y equals to 1. Log y base zx. Actually we know, all of us know, that log a base a equals to 1. That means log y base, this is base y, this is base y, have the same base. So this will be multiplied to get x, y, z. Okay, anyway, one mistake. I'm sorry that it is my mistake. Actually, A is given 1 plus. Okay, I have seen the question. A is given plus 1. I'm sorry, please write down it again. A equals to this plus 1. So log x, y, z. This is x, so I have to take log x dash x. Or A equal to log x base x, y, z. 1 by A equal to 1 by log x, x, y, z implies that A inverse equal to log x, y, z, x. I'm sorry, extremely sorry. Please have the correction. Actually, it was given 1. I didn't notice it. A equals to this plus 1. So this is x. So for 1, we can get log x plus x. And as we know, log a is a equals to 1. Now, we have the same basics. X has to have the multiplication here. So it has a multiply. Here, what we have done, we have just had the, application of inverted loop, and we know that 1 by A means A inverse, that is A to the power minus 1, and this has been exchanged. As usual math, B minus 1, then we can write here, I think I have copied it. After that, we can write here, or 1 by b minus 1 is equal to 1 by log x, y, z will be base, this is y, or log y x, y, z b minus 1 whole to the power minus 1 is equal to log x, y, z y. This is equation 2. And we get the last part, c equals to 3 plus log z x y, and here it is c minus 2, implies that c minus 2 equals to 3 plus log z x y minus 2. I have subtracted 2 from both the sides. 2 has been subtracted from both the sides. Or 1 plus log z x y, and like the previous 2 maths, 1 means log z base z, log z base x, y, log z, z same base, x, y, and z will be multiplied, x, y, z. That is, here, therefore, 1 by c minus 2 is equal to 1 by log z x, y, z. c minus 2 4 to the power minus 1 equals to log x, y, z, z. This is equation 3. Now we have to add all those three equations. One plus two plus three. What was equation one? Left hand side, e to the power minus one, b minus one, whole to the power minus one, c minus two, whole to the power minus one is equal to. It was log x, y, z, x. Then it was log x, y, z, y. And the third one was log x, y, z, z. I mean, I have added the left hand sides of all those three equations as well as the right hand sides of the same three equations. So here the same place x, y, z. So x, y, and z will be multiplied to get x, y, z. That is equal to 1. The formula log a base a equals to 1. That is log a base a equals to 1, as I told you earlier. So it is proved. If you have any question regarding this math, you can ask me. You think and just talk to me. How is your camera profile?
No.
What's wrong? Okay, now we are going to another question, that is Joshua Board 2020. At first, copy the math. Okay. This is, I am not mentioning the center, okay? A, B, C, D is a cyclic quadrilateral. So that so that the diagonals AC and BD intersect perpendicularly. It is given that they intersect perpendicularly. Now, if it is perpendicular, again, if it is perpendicular, and this is F, this is the point F, this is F, and this is E, and this is P. PF perpendicular to CD. Good. Question number A. PD equal to PD equal to 3 cm. PF is equal to 1 cm. Find the length of orthogonal projection. Find the length of orthogonal projection of PD on the line segment CD. Have you got it? PD is given as by 3 cm and PF is 1 cm. We have to determine the length of orthogonal projection of PD. Okay, on the line segment CD. Okay. Question number B. Prove that. A equals to B. Question number C. In triangle ABD, AB equals to AD, and the circumradius, of the triangle is R, prove that AB square equals to 2R into AD. Okay. Last day, I gave you some homework about 20 students sent me their homework through email. I was highly pleased. I want that every student will submit me the homework. Let us discuss this question. It is exercise 3.1 where the orthogonal projection was given. To find the length, to find the length of orthogonal projection of PD. So we will find the orthogonal projection of PD. Upon on the line segment CD. On the line segment CD. What will be the answer? Just stay constant. What will be the answer? Orthogonal projection of PD. Orthogonal projection of PD. I am discussing question number A. Question number A. Orthogonal OP, that means orthogonal projection. Orthogonal projection of PD on CD equals to what? Tell me. Can you tell me orthogonal projection of PD on CD? The value was given PD equals to 3 cm and PF equals to 1 cm. So what should be the answer? It is DF. So DF equals to what? Root over DF. It is 90 degree. So it's a right angle triangle. I have marked. It is a right angle triangle. So DF is equal to PD square minus PF square. Now we can put the value 3 square minus 1 square, that is root over 8, or we can write here 2 root 2 centimeter. Please get understand. Do you understand the orthogonal projection or not? This is the question. Suppose any triangle. This type of triangle has been taken. This is P, this is D, and this is C. Okay, I am trying to make you understand. Suppose a triangle is given. So, we have to find the orthogonal projection of DP on CD. So, a perpendicular is to be drawn. This is PF. Suppose. How to determine the orthogonal projection? Actually, it is nothing but the shadow. If light is reflected here, then this is the way to find. From D, there is a perpendicular DF. How you can determine the orthogonal projection? Please try to understand. From D, there is a perpendicular DF. Also from P, there is a perpendicular PF. I am going to find the orthogonal projection of PD. Please, so from P, there is a, from P, there is a perpendicular. PF. I am repeating the orthogonal projection. We have to determine the orthogonal projection of PD. Right? Okay. So, what I have to see? Ortho PD, from P, there is a perpendicular PF. From P, there is a perpendicular PF. From D, there is another perpendicular DF. From D, there is another perpendicular DF. C, this is vertical and this is horizontal. I mean, DF is horizontal and PF is here vertical. I have to find the orthogonal projection on CD. Where is CD? CD is in the horizontal. CD lies in the horizontal position. So one CD position lies, one CD position lies from these two. Definitely DF. Okay, you just wait. I am trying to make you understand in another way. Suppose this is the triangle. This is the triangle. This is D perpendicular. Okay, that's good. We have to find the orthogonal projection of AB on BC. Please get understand. We have to find the orthogonal projection of AB. On BC. So what we should do? See, from A there is a perpendicular AD. From A there is a perpendicular AB. From B there is another perpendicular BD. So answer will be AD or BD. But you have to see one BC segment, line segment BC. So along BC which one lies here? Along BC which one is there? AD or BD? AD and BD both are perpendiculars. Orthogonal projection of AB. So we have to find the perpendicular from the point A and from the point B. From the point A, AD is the perpendicular. From the point B, BD is the perpendicular. That's good. Now we have to see along BC which one lies, AD or BD? Definitely BD. Okay, so here. Along CD, which one lies? Definitely DF. So, it is a right angle triangle. Hypotenuse square is equal to sum of the squares of other two sides applying Pythagoras theorem. What is that? PD square is equal to DF square plus PF square. Now from here we can find DF square. DF square equals to PD square minus PF square. Or DF equals to what? Root over PD square minus PF square. That I have written it here. I think you have understood. Kuchh shodhe ho tum? Ye kuchh se kya kuchh hai? Okay. Question number B. Can you go to question number B? Who can tell me which theorem is mentioned here? Question number B. Just let me know. Write me. Which theorem? Question number B. Which theorem? Question number B. Brahmagupta's theorem. Question number B. Brahmagupta's theorem. Brahmagupta's theorem. So actually, next day I will start from Brahmagupta's theorem and Ptolemy's theorem. Okay. Now, I am going to question number C. Question number C. You have to draw the figure again. I have to see the question again. Oh, I'm sorry. Question number C. A, B, D. This is P. This is O. Sorry for that. AB equals to AD, AB equals to AD. It is the 2R into R. Okay. Okay, sorry. It is P. It is D. It is P. To prove that AB square equals to 2R into AB. This is R. Circumradius. R is the circumradius. So we can name it here, suppose Q. We join BQ. That's proof. These and these are equal. This is center. This is perpendicular. Angle ABQ equals to what? Can you tell me? Angle ABQ equals to one right angle. Because angle at the semicircle. Angle at the semicircle. This angle is 90 degree. Angle APD equals to one right angle. Why? Because AP is perpendicular to BD. AP is perpendicular to BD. Now, in triangle ABQ and triangle ADP, what we are getting equal? Initially we have got these two angles measure 90 degree individually. They are equal. Side note equal to 90 degree or one right angle. What else are equal here in this question? Who can tell me? This angle and this angle are equal. What the triangles I am going to consider? I am going to consider this triangle and this triangle, these two triangles, okay? I am going to consider this triangle and this triangle. This is 90 degree angle at the semicircle, and this is perpendicular given in the question. That's good. Here we see is standing on the same arc AB. Standing on the same arc AB, if we rotate the figure about an angle of 90 degree, and if we keep AB in front of us, if we rotate it, then we will see that standing on the same arc AB, standing on the same arc AB, we have two angles in the circumference. This angle and this angle. Have you got it? Standing on the same arc AB, we have two angles at the circumference. Angle AQB. Angle AQB is equal to angle ADP. ADP. This is D. Standing on the same arc AB. Standing on the same arc AB.
Angle BQ equal to AB.
Okay. Now, what else are equal here? Can you tell me? It's okay.
Camera shake it up.
Short set.
No, take us.
Okay. The remaining angle. Therefore, the remaining angle in triangle ABQ, what is the remaining angle? We see that this angle is still left. Angle BAQ. BAQ is equal to the remaining angle here, this angle DAP. DAP. Therefore, the triangles are equiangular and so they are similar. Okay? Triangles are equiangular and so they are similar. If two triangles are similar, then what we can say? We can say that their corresponding sides are proportional. Their corresponding sides are proportional. That day I taught you how to determine the corresponding or matching sides. Just to omit the midpoint. If you omit P, then we will be left with AQ. If we omit P, we will be left with AD equal to. If we omit Q, then we will be left with AB. If we omit D, then we will be left with AP. If we omit A, we will be left with BQ. If we omit A, then we will be left with DP. This is the way how we can find the corresponding sides of two triangles easily. I think you have got it. just to omit the midpoint. This P, B. So we will be left with AQ. This point P will not be considered. So we will be left with AD. AQ, AD. And similarly, other two pairs of sides have been written. One thing is to be remembered always. After this, sometimes we don't need all those three pairs of sides. See what you did in the construction. In the construction, you joined B and Q. So here, the part with BQ will not be considered else. We can write that is AQ by AD equals to AB by AP. Now we must have their cross multiplication. That is AB into AD is equal to AP into, write down AQ at first, AQ into AP. Now what's about AD? See the figure, look at the figure. At first it was told that AB equals to AD. AB and AD, in the question it was given that AB and AD are equal. That is, it's an isosceles triangle where AB and AD are equal. So for AD, we can write down AB as per the requirement of the proof. AQ, what is AQ? Can you tell me what is AQ here? If O is the center, it is the perpendicular. It is perpendicular because they are equal. They are equal for this, it is perpendicular. Okay. AQ is the diameter of the circle. AQ is the diameter of the circle. So if R be the circumradius, so what will be its diameter?
AQ is the diameter.
I am telling, if R be the circumradius, then AQ will be diameter, that is 2R. Diameter is twice the radius into AP. That means AP square equals to 2R into AP. We have proved it. Side note may be given here, that is AB equals to AD. And AQ is the diameter, we know. Dear students, thank you very much. No more today. Best of luck. Bye bye.